Hello and welcome again. On this video, I will teach you how to prepare this file so we can export it to Adobe After Effects. So let's begin. Before we begin, I want to acknowledge that I did some minor changes to this illustration between videos. For example, I added some extra lines to the coffee pot and changed some colors. I also changed the stroke weight of every line to 6.5. So having said that, let's begin with the content of this video, which is preparing the file. So first I'm going to take the layers panel and I'm going to drag it here so I have more room to work. And first of all, I'm going to delete the sketch layer because I don't need it anymore. And now I want to redistribute everything into separate layers. I want individual layers for each single shape of this illustration. For now, I'll start arranging some elements, for example the background. I'm going to take this big rectangle shape that is the background and I'm going to move it to a new layer. So I'm going to click and drag on this little square which represents the selected artwork and I'm going to lock this layer. Then I'm going to do the same thing with this bottom line that we have here on the illustration. I'm going to select it, click and drag on the square, and then I'm going to lock the layer. Okay, so far so good, but for the other elements this won't be so simple. So I'm going to click and drag to select every shape of this tall mug, and I'm going to Object Group, and I'm going to create a new layer and I'll call it Tall Mug. And now I'm going to take this little square and I'm going to click and drag it so it's all on the new layer. Okay, so now I'm going to do the same thing with the coffee pot. We're going to select everything, then right click and group, then create a new layer and call it coffee pot. And then I'm going to move this group to the coffee pot layer. Okay, so far so good. Now we're going to select everything here on the cupcake, group it, and then create a new layer, call it cupcake, and then I'm going to move the cupcake to its layer. And finally, I'm going to do the same thing with the last element, which is this mug. And once this mug is on its own layer, I'm going to delete the old layers that we had. Okay, perfect. Right now I'm going to ungroup everything that I have grouped previously by right-clicking and ungroup. Then I'm going to click on the target, which is this little round icon on the right side of the layer. I'm going to do this with every layer, but let's start with this one. I'm going to select this drop-down menu and go to Release to Layers Sequence. So as you can see here, every element that we had on this layer has moved to a new layer. And now we're going to do the same thing for the rest of the elements on this illustration. First I'm going to click on the target, which is this round icon, then Release to Layers Sequence. And I'm going to do the same thing with the mug. Always click on this drop-down menu and select Release to Layers Sequence. So as you can see, these are some kind of sub-layers. So we are going to actually take the time to rename each one of those sub-layers. Okay, so we're back. I have renamed all of the layers on this illustration. It took me some time, but it will save me a lot of time too afterwards once we are on Adobe After Effects. So now that we've finished organizing all the layers, I'm going to select all the sub-layers under this element, Tall Mug. And I can do that by selecting the first, holding Shift and selecting the last one. And then I'm going to click and drag it all the way to the top. And as you can see, the layer called Tall Mug is empty and we can delete it. Now we are going to repeat the same thing for the coffee pot. We are going to take all the soup layers and we are going to drag them outside. Perfect. Now we are going to delete the coffee pot layer. Then of course we are going to do the same for the cupcake. And finally we are going to do the same for the mug. Now we are going to unlock everything and there we go. Our file is finally ready. We are finally ready to start working on Adobe After Effects. Okay, welcome back. We are on After Effects now. And now we'll go to File, Import, File. And we are going to select the file that we were working with. and under this window we're going to select Import as Composition. Then I'll click on Open, and I'll double click on this composition that we have here. Okay, so as you can see, we have every layer here. As you can see, they are exactly the same as we had on Adobe Illustrator, the same names and the same order. So we're going to select all of these layers right now, which of course we can do by hitting the first one, then holding Shift and selecting the last one. Then we're going to right click and create shapes from vector layer. So now we had a duplicate of every layer on top of the old layers. And as you can see, they have a little star as an icon. So what is the difference between the old layers and the new ones? Well, these new ones are completely editable. So let me show you an example. I'm going to select this line, this fumes layer, which is called fumes outline because After Effects added the word outline to every new layer that I created. And as you can see, I can move this line, I can edit this line as if I were on Adobe Illustrator. So that is extremely helpful to what we are going to do next. So right now I'm going to select all of these old layers and I'm going to just hit delete on my keyboard. And now I'm going to start selecting all of the layers that belong to the same element. So for example, I'm going to choose every layer that belongs to the tall mug, which is from layer 1 to layer number 16. I'm going to select them all and I'm going to right click Precompose. Now this window will appear, so I'll enter tall mug as a name for the composition. And there we go, this is a precomposition and it's very similar to a group on Illustrator. For example, if I double click on it, I can see all the 16 layers that I grouped here. This is a very helpful tool to animate in a more organized way. So, of course, we are going to do the same thing for all elements on this illustration. I am going to now select all the layers that belong to the coffee pot, and I'm going to precompose them. So, it seems that the last layer that contains an element for the coffee pot is layer number 26. So we're going to select everything that goes from number 2 to number 26, right click, precompose, and call it coffee pot. Next, we're going to do the same thing for the cupcake, which are all these layers. So we're going to right click, precompose, and rename it as cupcake. Then finally, I'm going to do the same thing for the elements that belong to the mug, and I'm going to leave the final two layers, which are the background and the bottom line, as they are. Okay, so far so good. This is all for now. At this point, it would be good to go to Composition, Composition Settings, and check that we have 30 frames per second, which we have in this case, and if not, enter that number. And as for this number on the left corner, I like to control click on it so it's showing me frames instead of seconds, because we are going to do a very short animation and I want to guide myself using frames. Okay, this is all for now. Our file is finally ready and we can start animating on Adobe After Effects. So on the next video, I'll show you how to animate the lines of this illustration. See you there.